What's up, boys and girls on YouTube? So in this video, we are taking a look at this latest track that has come out with Kanye West featuring Eminem, and which supposedly Eminem has expressed a faith in Jesus Christ. I've got my friend Jeremy with me. He is in this video because he has listened to much more Eminem than I have in my life. I don't know much of anything about Eminem, but he does. So we're gonna dive in. You ready?
Ready.
All right, let's do it.
Let's hit it.
This is some profound lyrics right there.
Yeah.
Possibly.
Yeah. I think somebody only like Kanye West could just start the song with.
I just like how it's written down in this video
for
in particular.
50 seconds of the song. Right. Go ahead.
Use this gospel for protection. It's a hard road to heaven.
Joe Olsen will never tell you that.
We call your blessings and the Father.
Let it be known that his views are not my views.
Does that mean you're a Joe Osteen fan?
No, I don't know enough about the man to have a personal opinion.
I just like poking fun.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I think a lot of people do. I mean,
yeah.
Kingdom, the kingdom, our demons are trembling, holy angels defending, and the Father.
Oh, here it is.
I'm holding on, but I don't know if I can take it much longer. Today's the day that I put all of my trust and faith in you, Father. Please let this make me stronger, for they turn on me like a zombie. It's like I'm being strangled, unconscious. When temptation is almost like Satan is baiting you, trying to take you away from your daughters, dangling a bunch of painkillers on your way, venom in your face, and them Watsons coming extra strict. And that's why they make them in rectangular objects, because that's the shape of a coffin. Though it ain't medication, it's time, but the devil's taking me on, and I ain't gonna let him break me, because I'm a soldier you can bank on that promise, like the Chamber of Commerce. So my savior, I call on to rescue me from these depths of despair. So these demons better step like a stair, because he is my shepherd. I'm going with Jesus, my weapon is prayer. Sometimes I squeeze it, I'm blessed like sneezes. Call me Jesus, I'm effed in the head. Maybe I'm bonkers, regardless, never claim to be flawless. Long list of mistakes I've acknowledged. Don't wish I would say something positive. On the cave, and I'm positive. They'd rather trade with it with me, where they can stay with fair way. Better with the mods than they would exchanging. Some bars are trading, any bars with shady any property is painfully obvious to compare godliness to an atheist. But I got them audiences raving, and amidst my squabbles I got some awesome inspiration to draw from off on pen and paper. I'm knocking them off, up on stage in a concert, whole place that goes like a mosh pit, rival at my side like a rifle with a God-given gift. Every single day I thank God for, that's why I pay so much homage, praises to Jesus. I'll always
That's some bars right there.
It's a hard road to heaven. We call on your blessings and the Father. We put our faith. Kingdom, the kingdom. Our demons are trembling. Holy angels defending. And the Father.
Lyrics by Renor Susuri, just remember that. You have in a world where people are trying to move further and further away from the name of Jesus.
Right.
And you have Eminem of all people openly shouting out loud the name Jesus.
Right. My initial reaction is, I can't believe Eminem put out a whole song and not a single curse word.
Watch your profanity.
Not a single curse.
I mean, he said effed in the head.
Yeah, effed in the head.
But I mean, for Eminem, that's like...
Look.
You know, if Eminem does that, it is intentional. It's kind of like when people collaborate with NF. Whether he asks them to or not, it's like they honor his legacy of no curse words.
Yeah.
Did it for a while, wasn't into all the customs, trying to find who I was, being everything I wasn't...
And so it's kind of like Kanye has gone out on this thing where he's trying to avoid profanity in his music.
Right,
and so you see Eminem is willing to change his style a little bit.
Dom came out 2 days late because I took the cursing off, right? Because his families, they just don't need all that cursing in a living room.
One of the scriptures that, you know, comes to mind is you want to rid yourself of foul language, moral filth, anything that's detestable.
Well, that's also why I'm kind of always suspicious of people who claim to be Christians, but they're, especially with, I'm not bashing or trying to ridicule people, but there are a lot of rappers who claim to be Christians. You have Lil Wayne.
That's God. That's my family. That's my kids.
Kendrick Lamar. Mm. But you don't necessarily see it in their music or in their lyrics, yeah, or even outside of music. Yeah. But to me, that's a sign of maturity. You're growing in your faith with God, because that's what the process of sanctification is. God begins to pull out certain things about you,
right,
that are making you less like him. The big picture is that Eminem is rapping lines like, "Today's the day that I put all of my trust and faith in you, Father." I mean, I could start listing names of Christian artists who are distancing themselves from the church, distancing themselves from explicitly mentioning their faith in their right. songs because they right. want to seem cool or edgy, or they want everyone to be able to listen to the music. And it's like, of all people, Kanye West and Eminem are making them look bad.
You're ashamed of yourself.
In a way, it's a beautiful thing. The waters are stirring inside of the entertainment industry. People are starting to learn, you know what, it's okay to be rebellious. If the culture says you're not allowed to talk about God in your music, it's not profitable, it's not right. blah, blah, right, blah. Right. And these people are just saying, we don't care.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you.
We don't care.
I do want to address really quick those group of people who are going to say Eminem's just doing this for the money. Eminem is not doing this.
I don't think that.
That's ludicrous. Eminem has all the success, all the fame, right, and all the money in the world, and to think that he
think
was going to do this to make more money, I don't see how this could be anything other than sincerity.
Testimony.
Because he saw Kanye do this, and everyone turned on Kanye. He was losing hundreds, thousands, even millions of fans. For Eminem to see that happen to Kanye and to think, well, now I'm going to do the same thing, that's not someone who's saying, oh, let me see if I can make a couple dollars off of those Christians.
No.
What inspired you to
make song about Jesus?
Money.
I don't think that's the case here either, because as Joseph mentioned in the beginning of the video, that I've listened to more Eminem than he has. In other words, what he's saying is that I've lived a more pagan life than he has. I mean, I don't know enough about Eminem's personal life. I do know that I doubt he would need to use this venue or this platform to make more money. And if anybody knows anything about Eminem through his interviews, he doesn't really care about money. He'll wear a $100 watch, and when he owns a Rolex, you've never seen him with gold chains. So to say that, you know, Eminem is doing it for the money, I doubt it.
Kanye could never, I mean, people said Kanye could never be a Christian. They're gonna say Eminem could never be a Christian. But at the end of the day, we do not expect these people to be perfect overnight. It's about that initial decision. You put your faith in Jesus Christ, and then the process of sanctification begins, where God begins to purify one day at a time to kind of weed out some of those things that make us less like him.
Mm. I like to use the swimming pool analogy. Imagine you're standing on the edge of a swimming pool. You know, sin is the water, and you jump in and you go into water and everything's okay for a moment. And then you realize, I need air. You might be at the bottom of the pool, but when you realize that you need air, you start swimming towards the top, but you're not immediately at the top. You're not immediately breathing that oxygen. And in that instance, you know, the process of sanctification is a journey. So again, with people like Eminem, people with Kanye, are we gonna see them walking on water immediately? Probably not.
And are they gonna continue to make mistakes?
Oh, I mean, yeah, for sure. I do.
I mean, we were just talking before this video about things that have happened in Kanye's life since him becoming a Christian,
right,
where he's not necessarily always conducting himself in an honorable manner. I can say, I mean, I've been a Christian most of my life, and there have been periods of time where I did things where I was shocked and I said, oh my goodness, where did that come from? So at the end of the day, we do not expect perfection.
No.
But as long as every day you are part of this journey where you're becoming more like Christ, that is what really matters. I think at the end of the day, we have to view this with a balanced approach, in that we as Christians need to pray over these two individuals, and we need to pray blessings over them, that God would allow them to continue this journey. It's not our place to deem how spiritual or how godly they are. It is our job to pray, God bless Eminem, God bless Ye. And we pray that every day they would become more like you and continue this journey. There's also the balance. We still need to practice discernment. That doesn't mean Eminem rapped about Jesus, I'm gonna go listen to all his music now. No, that's not what that means. It means we need to practice discernment. And just because they now are walking towards Christ, becoming more like Christ, does not mean that anything that comes out of their mouth is going to be necessarily reflective of who God is or what God believes. So there's gotta be that balance of discernment. And there's gotta be that understanding at the end of the day. I had in my notes, Matthew 7:15-20. In a nutshell, it says, we will know people by their fruit. Obviously, the second you plant a tree, it does not start growing fruit. It takes time. And so if 10 years down the road, Eminem is still F-bombing in his music, I would be suspicious. All right, what's going on here? But if this is the start of his journey, time will tell. What is the fruit that he's going to bear? And we also have to be wary of false prophets. And so if these people come into the church intentionally trying to sow discord or false doctrine, which I do not believe they are trying to do, but we have to be vigilant and say, if this is what they're trying to do, then we have to distance ourselves from that. So there's a balanced approach. We're happy for what's happening. We're rejoicing in what God is doing in their life, but we're not going to go head over heels and listen to every Eminem song ever and begin to take every word that comes out of his mouth as a gospel. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed us just listening and breaking down our thoughts on this song. If there are any other songs you would like me and Jeremy to react to, just let us know in the comments below. And with that, you guys have an awesome day.